Welcome into the Go Home Rocket Pro Show version of the Power Hour. This Saturday in Joliet kicks on 66. And tonight, you know, usually it's the C-Red presents the Power Hour with Steve and Rion and 7K, and we've changed the name. But tonight it's actually the Idol Hour because surrounding us are the very, very impressive, very popular faction in the area, the Fabulous Idols. We have the rock star, Johnny Nye. We have Flash Harris. We have Damian Gray. And we have the name we cannot mention publicly without fear of being suspended on social media. So we have
Say my credentials, Steve.
Say it, you coward.
We have the Outer Limits champion. That is Gunner Brave. We have the Intercounty champion. That is Flash Harris. And we have the reigning, defending Rocket Pro Wrestling tag team champions. More on that in a few minutes. In the Rockstar Johnny Nye and Damian Gray. Gentlemen, you're packing a lot of gold. You guys have came, you saw, and the plan that you executed is certainly lined up for a success story this Saturday. Welcome on behalf of all of us to the Idol Hour. Red, it's the Idol Hour. What do you say about that?
What am I supposed to say? I'm happy. I'm ecstatic. I just wish Flash would get his face off the camera a little bit. You know, like you we're trying to count the blackheads on his nose or something.
You Flash, you could, when you get this angle of Flash, there are a few things about Flash that you don't always, that sometimes you forget, but when you see him up close, you tend to remember. The man has got just almond silk complexion, but he's got a lot of nose hairs. So it's a feast or famine scenario.
Steve, why are you looking up his nose?
Because it's right in my face.
He's giving us a beautiful close-up on the face of a champion. He's looking great.
If he was a Kleenex, I would appreciate this view much more, but since I am not, I don't need it. Rion Skills is also here, but I believe he's in mid-spin cycle. So as soon as he gets his laundry tended to, he will join us. He is not at this location tonight.
Okay, who is that?
The ghost in this house.
Steve, you killing a cat back there?
There are no cats here.
You sit on something?
We got plenty of illness in this house, but... But
that's what he sounded like when we were throwing him in the trunk.
Help me. Help me, please. Help me, please.
We got jokes. And that's fine. You can have the jokes. The laugh was certainly on me last month. No doubt about it.
I'm chasing waterfalls.
You know, honestly, Steve, you got a little bit lucky there because the way I see it, you got the only way that you didn't get tossed from up higher is because you were so annoying. Kevin couldn't keep you in the van for any longer, so we had to ditch you halfway up. It could have been a lot worse for you. So I think you should really be thanking us for that whole situation.
I'm sorry. Did I switch the audio to Long Island Vision? What the hell is that accent?
You know, Steve,
not all of MTV Beach.
I'm sorry, I can barely hear you over the seeming machine gun fire coming from Mr. Skills, who seems to be away from keyboard right now. But
he doesn't seem accent... that skilled. He might not be skilled at IT. Jesus Christ.
All right. Before we get into all of the things that went wrong and or right at the last Rocket Pro show, I always kind of like to know a little bit of background on the guests that we have.
See, this is the issue I have. You don't know how to take control of anything. You don't know how to take control of your life. You don't know how to take control of the commentary booth. You don't know how to take control of your health, your ties, those shades, whatever rides you take. You need to take control of your podcast right now. That's the problem. You invited Rion here. Mute him. Take control.
Rion is a valued member of this staff, and whether he's in a wind tunnel, in a spin cycle, whatever we will traverse through that. Wow, that was a whole lot of hatred. And here I am trying to be all professional and give you the respect that you deserve on this show. I was simply going to ask, tell me how the idols came to be. I like to know origin stories. I like to know how it happened. What brought you together? I'm trying to be a professional here, and you're throwing rivers at me and kidnappings at me and how I don't have control of my life. I'm trying to respect you. Why don't you show a little respect as well?
You know what, Steve? Flash,
you want to take this or you want me?
Anybody can. I have nothing.
You know, I think you two should take it. At least, at the very least, Idol's origins is the two senior most members on the call in terms of seniority, in terms of longevity.
Well, the Idol started in IPW with Mr. Flash Harris, Joey Roth, and at the time, I believe Tully Bertarelli was the third member. I was not there at that particular juncture, so sure, I don't know exactly how long it was that three-piece. I'm speaking, Stephen.
Mute yourself.
But this version of the Idols was constructed and came to be, I would say, when Flash, myself, and Mr. Joey Roth came up with the plan to swerve Tully by getting this man the IPW World Championship, which he still owns. Was kind of how our trifecta came to be. We were brought over to Rocket Pro Wrestling because we were so dominant in IPW. And this year, you know, we were treated as a comedy act at first, which I explained to you in that promo video that you so disrespected because it was 5 minutes long. Oh, your precious time couldn't last 5 minutes to hear the origin story on the promo. So I have to repeat this to you. So I'm just going to say this again so that you can fully understand. So when we came to Rocket Pro, we were disrespected. We were treated like clowns, like the comedy act of the night, always put into matches with weird people that are come out and clap and dance around. It was a joke. And that isn't who we are. That is never who we were. And we just didn't like that. We were not okay with that spot on the card. It was a disrespectful situation. So we proceeded to take matters into our own hands. Starting this year, we set this plan in motion. It started the previous year during the pandemic, where Flash Harris won the Intercounty Championship, which he still owns today. Then the next step was to take your hero, Mr. Gunner Brave, and stop from being Mr. Jump off everything and bring all the crowds, but never get the respect. He does what he wants now, when he wants now, and now he's a champion. And then the next step, which I told you, everything that I'm telling you now, I told you before it happened, was these tag team titles from your precious young. Didn't stand a chance.
Johnny, hold on. Rion, I'm looking at you because it's you. Put down the damn Nintendo Switch. Put yourself on mute. Mute. Is he ignoring me? Is he ignoring me?
Does he know he's in the call?
Yes, he's making this face on purpose. He's trying to piss me off.
I need another drink.
Johnny, I want you to have the respect that you deserve. Okay?
All this damn wind.
Yes, and he's not even going anywhere.
I thought Steve was the one full of hot wind here. Come on.
Have you ever heard Rion talk?
Rion, there you go. Why are you dogging Rion?
It's Johnny's floor now. Shut up.
So after we took these tag team titles, that's pretty much where we are today. And the next step, as you know, is to take over the company. To finish the job this Saturday. I mean, that's the long and the short of it. I can exaggerate or elaborate on anything you'd like, Stephen, but that is the timeline of the idols.
That is a very impressive recount of the timeline. And, you know, a very impressive rise to prominence indeed. You talked about the idols being treated like a joke, which I get. I kind of see where that might be true. But honestly, I think when you did snatch up Gunner Brave, it gave instant credibility and respectability to a very, very tired product. It kind of rebranded it, as you will. It took very vanilla talent and kind of spiced it up a little bit. Whose idea was it to retool this very sad legacy with exciting new possibilities to get where you are?
You know what, Steve? I think you're the retool here, first and foremost. Let's just get that out of the way. The idols from the get-go have been Class A talent that's been given Class D opportunity. What we did, not to, you know, knock off what Gunner adds to the team. He's an incredible wrestler, one of the best. He wanted to join the hottest faction in Rocket Pro Wrestling, because here's the thing. Everyone that's doubted the idols hasn't been paying attention. Since the get-go, we have been saying precisely what we're gonna do and getting it done. And everyone acts surprised. They were surprised when I turned on Sean Danger and joined up. Yet there were posts all over social media of me and Joey dating back to 2019. They were surprised when Gunner turned their back on the fans. When you see the way those fans have acted, you see what makes them cheer. They disgusted him. They were all over him. He couldn't breathe. He decided to make an intelligent move and put himself first, just like I did. And by putting ourselves first, we have formed a cohesive unit and an elite legion. So that's what you've seen. We all had our own individual talents that are incredible on their own. But when we come together, we are unstoppable. And that is what you've seen, you retool.
Well, okay. You know, these are all very, very valid points, and I get it. And I want to dwell into something that you said with that very, very impressive clarity of mind. You said it was Gunner who wanted to join the hottest faction, you know, in wrestling. And, you know, he certainly did. But instead of joining the hottest faction wrestling, those damn Coyotes, he ended up with the idols. So, I mean, can you clarify Steven, that scenario?
Steven, gentlemen, let me chime in on this one.
Go ahead.
Shall we talk about those damn Coyotes for a second? Let's list off the four members of the Coyotes. So, Damian Deschain, I faced him in his specialty match, and I left him unconscious in the ring.
And Connor Hopkins, faced him, took him out.
Yes. Connor Hopkins, 3-on-3. I beat him in Rocket Pro's first ever match back, beat him. Brooks Berna, I've beaten Brooks Berna in one of the most hardcore matches Rocket Pro will ever see.
No doubt
and
about that.
And to this date, your world champion of Rocket Pro Wrestling, the unbeatable Christian Rose, has only lost to one person, me. So why would I join a group that I easily ran through? How are they the hottest group when they can't beat one man?
Those are all interesting points. I am talking about the applause of the crowd seems very loud when those coyotes are around and they seem to be.
Hell with the crowd. Right. Hell with the crowd.
You've seen what makes them cheer. Come on. What makes you think that the crowd actually matters? All right. The crowd are the same people that are putting the Kardashians up on a pedestal and buying everything that they see on television. That's what the crowd does. That doesn't make something truly elite.
That poorly at crowd might be top one worst crowds that I've ever seen. They are 90% idiot. The other 10% are just there for the $3 beers. And that's really all that matters. Okay, Rion, you can stop. Because I know what you're here for.
And on top of it, we beat the Coyotes in six-man tag action. So what are you talking about? The biggest faction in Rocket Pro Wrestling is the Coyotes. They've never beaten us.
Rocket Pro Wrestling champion Christian Rose, I've only ever faced him the once, and who came out on top? I'm undefeated against the current champion here. I mean, you want to talk about hottest faction in the company. That's the hottest faction in the company, and I'm going to keep that streak going this weekend when we go 5-on-5 with Mr. Rose, I suppose, captaining the other team. He's the only one over there with a belt, and I count four right in this call right now.
I think we have basically all of them. We're missing one belt. Just one belt. Oh, no.
You know, I'm
Wait. Who is the longest reigning champion in Rocket Pro history? Who has the longest solo title run in Rocket Pro history?
Well, when you fight
Answer the question. Answer the question. You would fail a test in college right now. I can tell you don't have your degree. So answer the question. Follow along.
You look like a bad politician and you dodge questions like one too. Answer it.
Right. Answer the question. Say his name. Say his name.
Let's see.
Say his name.
I'm thinking. There are a lot of championships.
Longest reigning defending.
Wait a minute.
No matter what you have
about
it.
Go to a WWE event. Is that a belt you bought at the merch table?
Oh well, it's the belt that I did. It's the belt that I defended against Maximus Orion last month. You should ask him how he's feeling.
I don't see that title very often. So can I see it again? I'd like to.
It's okay. You want to know why you don't see it very often? Because a champion like myself can only defend it when he feels like it. When you've reigned as long as I have, I control the tables. Nobody else controls those tables there. I make, as a matter of fact, just to show you last month, I didn't even have a match. I sanctioned that match. See, I don't think you realize, but the idols run RPW. No matter what you've been thinking, there is no not yet. See, there's a legal way of doing things, and then there's an illegal way of doing things. And we do things our way. And we're going to stay on this left-hand side. We don't need a match to dictate whether or not we want to take control of this sorry-ass company right now.
Sorry-ass company?
We run this. We run this company. This is our company. There's not a single talent that can match up to Damian Gray. There's not a single talent that can match up to Gunnar Bray. There's not a single talent that can match up to Johnny Nye. There's not a single talent that can match up to Big Daddy Damn Flash Harris. And I want you to remember that. No matter when I step in that ring, no matter whether I'm outside that ring, no matter whether I have a microphone in my hand or not, there's not a single person who wants to walk in, step up, and look at me square in my face and tell me they want to challenge me and do exactly what I do.
Yeah, because every time somebody steps up, you turn and run.
I turn and run? I make the challenges here.
Red,
I can choose when and what I want to do something.
I can't work with this guy anymore. He's completely off the rails. Red, take it. Get your boy. Get control of your show.
I'm going to disagree with him?
You're going to disagree with that garbage that just came out of his mouth?
What? That we
well,
run
let,
the company?
Let's put everything into perspective.
Listen up.
I see Johnny Nye with the title. I see Damian with the title. I see Gunner with the title. And again, the longest reigning, defending, undisputed inter-county champion.
Flash
Harris.
Harris.
I mean.
Oh, my God.
whether you like it, and clearly you don't, you have to accept.
You can't argue with accolades. You can't.
These gentlemen that we have brought on tonight are the cream of the crop of Rocket Pro.
We are the Tom Brady of Rocket Pro Wrestling.
And let me just...
Except we don't kiss our sons on the mouth.
There you go. See, that's why me and Flash Harris are friends.
Collectively, we are the Tom Brady's of Rocket Pro Wrestling.
There we go. See, that's why we are friends. Let's be honest, Steve. I've been telling you for months, and you don't listen. And... Let's go back some months when Gunner and you put everything into Gunner and you loved Gunner so much and he was your heartthrob. He was your next big thing. And then he broke your heart.
It was a little crazy.
And it's not the first time that I've seen this happen. And I told you it would happen and you didn't want to listen. And we're here. I told you your beloved No Coast would fall. I told you that. I told you that the idols would become tag team champions. And as I'm looking at my screen, I see tag team champions. They've already just told you. They, whether you like it or not, they control Rocket Pro. You don't like it. And I get it. I get it, Steve, that you didn't like having your ass handed to you, thrown in the trunk for the second time since I've known you.
Shouldn't have been talking shit.
Might have been more. And
next now, time you have to have duct tape, pal.
Now everything hinges on Saturday, Steve. I really want you to think about that. That these gentlemen that you're belittling might be your bosses. And I believe they will be after Saturday. And what happens then, Steve? Will you have a job?
Maybe
will yes, you be, Steve. Will you what be sweeping up the popcorn afterwards instead? Or will you get thrown in another trunk, this time driven further away?
You got embarrassed.
I'm just saying. You at this point, you need to stick to the questions, take your personal feelings out, and let these gentlemen answer these questions. Because again, the proof is in the pudding.
You know, Red, that's fair, and I accept that. So I'll move on to my next question.
Steve, I just want to say one thing. Individually, you have to respect all of us for what we single-handedly can bring to the company. Gunner Brave is the bar setter. I'm the trendsetter. Damian Gray and Johnny Nye are the needle movers of the tag team division. No matter what you feel, no matter what personal feelings you have about it, they are the needle movers of the tag team division. Because all we've seen so far is No Coast and those damn Coyotes. But at the end of the day, you see who have the champions. You see at the end of the day who has the most consistent record as far as wins go. Those are the needle movers right there. You need to respect them for what they are. Given no matter how you feel, you need to get your feelings out of it, you know, get your panties out of a bunch. Look, take your hand like this. I want you to do one thing. Take your hand like this. Put it up in the camera. Take one finger like that. Two fingers. Three fingers. Four fingers. Five. Let that hate go. Thank you.
Oh. And if I may bounce off of my boy Flash for a second, not that I really care if Steve cares or not. Steve, I have a question for you. I'm going to make a proclamation. I have a proclamation to make, and then I'm going to present you evidence, and I'll ask you a question. My proclamation is the formation of the Idols proper, which is the group of five we have now, once we came into full strength,
the Idols
is proper. is the greatest thing to happen to Rocket Pro Wrestling. And here is my question to you. Since December, when the Idols proper came to be, have we not consistently packed the house every single time? And were we not getting those numbers beforehand? From a business standpoint, Steve, you're a businessman and so am I. From a business standpoint, has the formation of the Complete Idols not been the greatest financial and publicity speaking thing to ever happen to Rocket Pro Wrestling? You might hate us, but we bring in money. We bring in fans. We are what Rocket Pro Wrestling is breathing off of right now. That company would be nothing if it wasn't for us.
That hate brings in the dollars.
I was prove just me wrong, gonna Steve. Say that. I was just gonna make that point. The idols equal money. We have doubled attendance since December. Every month we have so it was 200 before we got together. And now we're packing the place standing room only. Can't fit any more people in the building.
There's only out of beer.
Yeah, we ran out of beer.
Sorry, I might have contributed a little too much to that one, but wanted to make the point. Continue, Johnny.
It's honestly, when you look at it, who is the ones that are cutting the promos to promote these shows? It's not Team RPW. Have you seen any? Because I haven't. Where's your champion? Where's Christian Rose? Where's Mr. The promo's too long? I don't hear him. Did he go mute? Did all of the rest of them go mute? Are they not capable of cutting a promo? I'm not sure what the issue is, but they're not selling the show. We are. We're the money, we're the draws, and that's why we're taking over the company. And there's not a damn thing that anybody can do about it. And you're just gonna have to sit there at your little table and love it. Because if you don't, you might find yourself in a deeper lake.
Talk well, your shit, Johnny.
Oh, I will answer Gunner Brave's question with, since December, the numbers in attendance have gone up significantly.
Yes.
Is it the idols? Is it coincidence? I don't know. I guess having superstars like, you know, Marche Rocket and Marin have no bearing on attendance, right?
Okay. You know what, Steve? The fact of the matter is we're the ones that are performing in every other match on the card. All right? You can point out the individuals that we have individually taken out, taken down, decimated, picked apart, and dissected. That's fine. You can pick all the individuals that you want. But the one thing that's consistent that all those people have faced and have been beaten by and beaten down by is the idols. We're the one consistent thing through each of those cards every single month. So you can attribute it to one person here or there. But every show has already been the idols show. The only difference now is we're finally making it official.
And there's no denying the talent of Marche or Grin. I don't discount their talent. But Marche's been here since the beginning. So why all of a sudden is the numbers double in attendance? Like, can you explain? I would like you to explain it. Just justify it for me if you don't believe that it's us. That's what I would just like.
Red?
Just a correction, Johnny. He was not at Rocket Pro at the beginning.
Well, he's been there for longer.
He's been there longer, but he hasn't. He wasn't there.
All right.
Trust me. Unfortunately, I know.
Simpler times.
My next question is for Rion Skills.
Please, let's hear Rion talk for once.
Rion, help.
That's not a question. That's a statement.
That's that, yeah.
Jeez.
That's more of a request.
Or a proclamation, even.
Dedication.
What's happening? What's happening?
He can't even be bothered to pay attention to you, Steve. That's how boring that you are. He doesn't know what you were talking about. See, he drones it out just like I do when you speak.
No. He said, we are in help. I'm not sure. What do you want me to help with?
Apparently, he would
be alone on an island here.
Yeah, maybe it's because you're wrong. Have you ever considered that, moron?
What do you want me to say? Like, are we doing a work or a shoot? What do you want me to say about this?
It's a work. Okay. Shoot.
Every person in there has beaten the shit out of me. What do you want me to say? Take another ass whooping from them? What do you want me to do? I've been fighting Flash and Nye since the beginning of Rocket Pro. The reason that the idols are in existence is because I failed. It's that simple. I failed. Me and Roth went at it head up, and I thought I had them. And every time, just unlike any other scenario that I've ever been a part of, it's supposed to happen where if you cut the head off of the snake, that's it. These motherfuckers keep growing. There's nothing. You can't fight everybody. You can't do it. I have fought every single idol in existence. And every time that I have dealt with it, I've lost. Even if I win a match, I've lost. I have to have some mystical being like Santa Claus to help me at certain points because there's no one on the roster based on my experience alone, just my experience, no one else's, has been able to handle the idols in a proper way, going back to what Gunner Brave was saying. I thought I was on the same page as Gunner Brave. Apparently not. But if I'm taking as many ass whoopings as I was taking, I can see why Gunner Brave would join the idols too.
So
what do you want me to say, Steve? They've beaten the shit out of me for years. Why would I say anything now to take another ass whooping from the idols?
Undeniable.
He learned his lesson and you haven't learned your lesson.
We are undeniable.
Go ahead.
That's what we've been trying to do this whole time. That's what I've been saying in every video that I've sent out, every communication that I've made, is that whether you like us or not, that doesn't matter. We do what it takes. We get the job done. And at the end of the day, when we're in control, you have no other choice but to accept who's in control. That's what I've been saying since the beginning.
And it's crazy because the Rocket Pro fans can indirectly blame Rion for our success. His failure led to so much of our own successes that we are here where we are today because of Rion. So in essence, Rion helped the idols become the idols. He's not an idol, but he is an idol because if he wasn't an idol, guess what? It's all Rion's fault. Like you said, it's all Rion's fault. He created this ball.
Here's to Rion.
Does that make him an unofficial, unwilling honorary idol? Yes, it does.
Wow. If I had another person put me in another group.
Technically.
Hey, you don't have to be in it. You don't have to be in it.
And that other group you're talking about, you never left. So.
Hey, you know what's even crazy?
You know what? I'm playing Tetris. Let me play Tetris. I'm gonna go back over here.
We are having an off season at the beginning of a monstrous run. Come September, Rocket Pro is in session for the most hellacious 2022-2023 season that they've ever seen, with utter dominance from the idols.
You know what, guys, and I'm curious to hear what you guys think and if you guys will agree with this, particularly you, Steven. I want to hear what you think about this, because I think this weekend, when we're victorious, when we take control of the company, I think that that's going to truly mark the beginning of the idol era of Rocket Pro Wrestling. Think about it. We're done with the pandemic. That whole era is over. Shogun, who was a great champion, who carried us through the pandemic era, has fallen. And I took a bat to his head.
So at this point,
I think that era is dead and gone, and this is going to be finally the coronation, the christening of the idol era, and a true, new, distinct era for the company. What do you guys think?
I'm tired of
y'all smacking people in the head. Stop smacking people in the head with stuff.
You got a big-ass head like that, Rion. It's hard to miss.
This message goes that's for exactly who it's for.
Stop smacking people in the head.
This message has exactly who it's for. Dead roses have no value. Whoever that goes to, they know it's exactly for them. But remember, dead roses have no value whatsoever.
I think you kind of hit the nail on the head a little bit there, Flash. Did you make it?
Will you stop?
Smacked it right in the head. Smacked it right in the head.
Okay, well, so, I got 2 points. First, Flash. Dead roses do have values, especially the goth chicks. I don't know why, but
okay, yep.
But you know,
okay.
Respect. Hey, I'm just answering the question.
Just turn your chair around.
Shut the fuck up. It's my show. Second of all, Damien, I disagree. Here's why I disagree.
Turn my AC off. Hold on.
Bootleg AC doesn't cut off by remote. Damien, this is why I disagree. This whole time, it's been the idol era.
You're damn right. You talk your shit, Red. Keep going.
Absolutely.
If you pay attention again, what you've been doing, it hasn't been about anybody else but the idols. And I seen, first of all, I want you guys to take credit where credit is due. I watched the footage. What you guys planned and what you succeeded to do, I want you to think about this in its splendor. You took a company and you made them sign a contract stating that this Saturday, everything is on the line. Complete ownership. Like, guess what? When you guys win, you can start firing motherfuckers. Like, right after the win, you can just walk in the back. You fired. You can go fire the whole staff. Like, you can tell Steve and his partner, you're banned from the building forever, never to return. You guys have so much power. And why? Because you meticulously planned it out. So this whole time has been the idol era. Nobody was, see, you guys were so under the radar with it, nobody saw it coming.
I did. From every ass whooping I took.
Okay, so one person saw it coming. But guess what? Did he do like Paul Revere and run in and say, hey, the idols are coming?
I did.
He tried.
Clearly nobody listened. Therefore, the whole fate of a company, is all based on, and let's look at the people you guys are facing. Let's be honest. Christian Rose, as you guys have stated, has been quiet this whole time.
Crickets.
And I'm all on social media and all on social media presences, and I haven't seen him say anything. Like, I saw more when he had the briefcase than now he's got the title. So what does that say? That he got what he wanted and he's really done? So is he all in for Rocket Pro?
You know, C-Red, I think you're bringing out a really good point here. First off, I want to say thank you for the praises. It truly does seem as though great minds do think alike. For coming from a legend like yourself, that's incredible.
It's fact. It's not praising that. You look at it every show and the idols again. Think about you brought up this point. 8 matches on the card. Every other damn match is an idol match.
Mm-hmm.
Like, damn, y'all getting paid. I ain't mad at you.
So I want to do. I do want to be respectful to our competitors.
So, why?
Because at the end of the day, you do have to give them each individually their own little totem.
That's exactly where I was going.
You have to give them their totem. Aaron Stone, month in and month out, has been consistently shutting it down. Him and Gunner tore the house down whenever they were.
And then I beat him.
But
then you beat Gunner, him. Then you
Gunner,
beat him.
Gunner,
beat
Gunner,
him.
Gunner.
Oh, hey.
You still got that piece of hardware by you?
Yeah, let's show it. Just show it.
You still got that piece of hardware? Because Aaron Stone doesn't have that.
That's how it ended up.
Aaron Stone doesn't have that. See right there. Stone doesn't have that.
Okay, but then we can move forward. You have Shogun, and then Shogun.
As you stated, he broke through the pandemic, but he can beat Marche Rocket. And see, here's the thing.
Mm-hmm. You already on 18,
where a company, their whole future is around two of your people hate each other.
Three.
They despise
three. To be honest, three.
Well, it's three, but I know Marche, and Steve knows I know Marche well.
I know you know Marche well.
I don't see them working together.
I don't see any of them working together.
I honestly see Chris Logan getting his head handed to him, reaching out, and Marche is standing there. Marche decides he wants to take a 5-minute break, which he deserves. He works hard, but I don't see it. When I see this unit, I see a cohesive unit that flows like a river.
That was going to be my exact point. We're always two steps ahead. We have a cohesive plan. We all know our role and we work together. They're all incredible on their own. They have lineages and legacies, but time and time again, when they stood against us alone, they got crushed. You throw 5 men together, that doesn't mean they're together. They're still going to be standing out there alone. They're not going to work together. They're not a unit like we are, and that's the difference. That's what allows us to be two steps ahead of everybody from the get-go.
And I think the major issue that they're going to have is that we actually do understand that they are great individually and have respect for the greatness that they have accomplished. The problem is they have no respect for us. And that's where they've made a huge mistake.
That's
where they are going to regret it.
That's where we're going to make an example.
Respect the idols and what we bring to the table, and that will be their demise.
God damn it.
And will not be able to withstand what we bring to the table.
Exactly, Johnny. Exactly. Hey, Steve, can I point something out to you real quick?
You're gonna anyway.
So yeah. you remember how I was talking about how we take everything over? Do you realize that we took over your podcast today?
Yeah, you haven't asked a single question.
We will not let you answer or ask a single question.
You don't deserve it.
We're doing right now exactly what we're going to do to Rocket Pro on Saturday. Take over. Do what we want. Ask the questions we want. Make the decisions that we want. Fight who we want. Fire who we want. Hmm. You know, we can do what we want. No, Rian, you can't go. No.
I have a question.
No, you cannot get fired. You cannot get fired. You can't get fired.
Oh, yeah. Is it possible to sign a pink slip?
No. If anything, I'm actually going to give you overtime. You're going to be working more.
Unpaid, of course.
Unpaid.
Unpaid overtime, of course, but overtime nonetheless.
You are going to be double shooting from September to January.
I have another question. If that no. I guess this is it. I have a serious question. Actually, it's two. So this is elimination, correct?
Yes, it is.
Correct.
Okay. So I hope I'm going to word this the word. Okay. So let's just say that for some odd reason, not saying that it would happen, but let's just say that it ends up to where there's one person on Team Rocket Pro. Just one. It ends up you guys have beaten everyone or whatever. What happens if that one person ends up knocking you guys down?
That's a very solid question. See, the thing is, when what people haven't realized about the idols is that we always rebuild. No matter what happens. Adversity, there's adversity. You have situations where things like that. Okay, come on, go around. What you had a follow-up?
That's kind of what, that was kind of where I was going, because I mean, you guys have always had numbers and you guys have been pretty good about going about stuff. I mean, that's what took me out repeatedly. Mm-hmm. So what happens if the number game doesn't work?
I've seen crazier things happen. If the numbers game don't work, then we adjust.
Rion, there's always a plan. There's always a strategy. There's always a backup plan, second backup plan. We have every contingency worked out. But what good would all those plans be if we revealed them all over social media a few days before?
You know what? You're right.
Yes, please don't reveal yourself.
I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back to doing this.
No. We like this. Stay. No.
I've been too serious into the thing here.
No. Fuck that Tetris game.
The fact of the matter is, we aren't gonna be down on numbers. We aren't gonna be losing. We are going to be dominant from the get-go. We are going to be smarter. We are going to be faster. We are gonna be better organized. And that's how it's gonna go down. There's not another doubt in my mind.
I love it. So I think we have to give Steve his podcast back so he can ask us questions. Because he's been waiting. I think he has another question. He has one loaded.
This Saturday, May the 14th, Rocket Pro Wrestling presents Kicks on 66. And it's going to be one hell of a night, one hell of a show, one hell of a season finale. You have got No Coast taking on the Kings of the Six in tag team action. You have got a WFAC cruiserweight title match between Jake Lander and Sabotage. You've got the Ryan Matthews taking on the technical coyote, Damian Deschain. You have got the RPW Chicagoland Championship Fatal 4-Way featuring champion Turtle, Mike Brennan, versus Ruthless, Rockin' Rivera, versus Just Amazing, versus Garrison Creed. And whoever wins that match will walk away with a brand new title to Rocket Pro Wrestling. You also have in tag team competition Warhoss, Crosshairs Kelly, and Pat the Butcher taking on those damn coyotes in Brooks Berna and the Wild Child, Connor Hopkins. And then, of course, we have in women's competition Amaris Blair taking on Celine Gray. So this night is
no relation.
Whether or not anybody cares about the 5-on-5 elimination match that happens to be our main event. I do have one more question for all of you. Now, I understand why you decided to rain down hell on me and choke me out with electrical tape, beat me up, throw me into a garbage can, throw me into the back of a car, and dump me in the Joliet River. I get why you did it. Maybe I even deserved it a little bit. But what you did to the Shelleys is gutless, cowardly, unbecoming of men. You should be ashamed of yourselves for conducting your affairs in that way, gentlemen.
Look me in the face and ask me if I care about the Shelleys.
I find it very hard to look you in the face, man, because you've descended your title once, so you're half a champion.
Look me in the face.
I've defended
you
my
ask a question.
Your better half has his hand up.
Gunner Brave, what's Brave on your mind, son?
Stay.
I mean, we can actually talk now because your family, you know, has suspended me on social media. They reported me and got me banned. So you did a great job, guys. Way to go, fam.
Steven.
Wow, actions Steven, have consequences.
Steven, for the last
time. Say that again.
Steven, if you mention my family one more time, you'll be in the hospital bed right next to Maximus Orion. So watch your mouth when you talk to me, okay? Now, if you want to know what's on my mind is the fact that if you ask and ask and ask, nothing happens. You need to get shit done. We wanted everything. We got everything. And then there was nothing else to grab. We're like, well, let's get more. So we took everything into our own hands, and we forced the blade into where we wanted. So we went after the Shelleys because that's the last pinnacle. We wanted that title. We asked Marche to join us. He didn't want to join us. He turned his back on us. And now look where he's at, without a title on a losing team. So we wanted more. So we knew the only way to get more is to go after the top. And not only did we go after the top, we injured their son, we injured the husband, and we left the wife a shambling, crying mess. So what is on my mind, the only thing on my mind is that in, what is it, Wednesday, in 4 days' time, whatever days, I don't care, I'm looking across the ring from five men. And gentlemen, my fellow idols, you've given these men a lot of respect. I will do exactly the opposite. I don't care about respect. I'm looking at five men. I'm looking at Grin, a legend. Yeah, a legend 10 years past his prime. Aaron Stone, the dream breaker, the guy who can kick and chop hard. I'm 3-0 against him. He's not an issue. Christian Rose, the world champ, you won it off of cash in. You were doing nothing before. You're doing nothing now. You'll do nothing after. Marche and Shogun, the two ex-champions. X means they lost. They are losers. All of them are losers. We are winners. We are champions. We have proven to be champions, and we will continue to be. So what's on my mind, Steven, is you need to respect us when you talk to us. You need to keep my name, my family's name, and all of our names out your damn mouth unless you're saying our praises and giving us all the courtesies that we deserve. And when you are there on Saturday, you will see a continuation of what we do month in and month out. We win because we plan better. We work together better. And overall, we are better. So what's on my mind? What's always been on my mind? The idols are better. Enough said.
Jesus Christ.
I'll praise the idols. The plan was good. Solid. You got what you wanted. Very well done. Only Rion saw the plan. Nice work. You guys are on the precipice of taking over this company. Congratulations. It's an amazing thing. But see, here's the thing that bothers me. You put your hands on my broadcast colleague.
Yeah.
You put your hands on my broadcast colleague again, and I don't care who you are. I don't care what you do. I don't care what you think of me. You'll have to kill me.
Don't say something like that because I will oblige.
Yo, Steve.
Okay. Once you step in the ring, you are fair game. It doesn't matter if you're a fan, security guard, a grandma, an aunt, a child, anybody. You step in between those ropes, you make your decision. You are fair game. You know what you're doing. If you stepped in that ring, I would whoop your ass up and down that ring, corner to corner, rope to rope, mat to mat. I would kick your ass day in, day out. That's what happens. So if Shelly decides to get in the ring, that's her decision. It wasn't us. We didn't force her. She decided to get in the ring. She decided to chastise us. If me
she slapped me in the face.
If we decided to take the both of our chairs and smash her brains together like we were initially going to do, we will be 100% justified because she chose to get in the ring and confront us. I do not care. Guess what? Cry two tears in a bucket. Fuck it.
Steve, the Shelleys are a mean to an end. It's all just a means to an end. It's time to take old Yeller out behind the shed. Take all these old legends and put them out of their misery and begin this new era. So whatever we have to do, whoever we have to hurt, and whoever stands in our way, it's a means to an end. And the ends will justify the means. So make all the threats you want, but this weekend, you're gonna see how it's really gonna go.
The fact is, your broadcast partner got off easy. He didn't do anything to her. He just held her back. That could have gotten a lot worse for her. We were nice. We were trying to be respectful. Now, you on the other hand, Stephen, you already know what happens. So you better stay at that booth and do your job. We don't want to end up in a deeper lake, do we?
Gentlemen, Steve has never been to war. So Steve doesn't quite understand what it means to go to war. So Steve, I'm going to enlighten you. And not as a legend or icon, as you call me, but as a veteran, I'm going to enlighten you. When you go to war, you create a plan. And as I stated earlier, everything, month by month, was meticulously planned. Don't you think what happened? Let's be honest. I'm going to be honest. Flash, you should be locked up somewhere. The assault, but it happened. Now he's in a hospital bed.
We might all be accessories at this point. You guys are getting
but
out of
it. Was a plan. And for your broadcast partner, see, you always want to defend your broadcast partners, but I never see them defend you. Ever. You puff up your chest and say, "Don't you dare touch her or I'll..." Steve, when has she ever puffed up her chest and defended you?
They literally moved out of the way when we beat him up and took him.
I watched and laughed.
They moved out of the way.
Steve, understand what's happening Saturday.
Fucker.
What's happening? Do you think it wasn't planned? In war, you plan. I've told you that for years. I always have a plan. I know where these gentlemen come from. We kind of walk the same road. So their plan will come to fruition Saturday. Now, Steve, I need you to behave. Next week, the C-Red Power Hour with Steve and Rion 7K might just be C-Red and Rion.
Hold on. I got to pause that. You got to calm down on that. Steve and B. Somebody got to ask questions. How am I supposed to play Switch and eat Pop Tarts and everything if you don't sit there? I don't know if you pay.
Rion might actually have to do his job.
I was like, wait a minute. You got to calm down. Steve got to be here to do stuff.
Steve has to calm down.
Rion has to do what he has to.
So Steve, this is what I need you to do. Tonight is Wednesday. So forget tonight. Thursday, Friday. This is what I need you to do. I need you to find a quiet place, light some candles, and just meditate on the future. Meditate on the future of how the idols will now control and run the show. I need you to accept this and embrace this. And on Saturday, as you're sitting at that commentary table and you're calling all of these wonderful matches, when the main event happens, take your personal feelings out. Call it down the middle. And at the end, when the idol's hands are raised, rejoice.
It's what I do. Why do you think
rejoice.
I can sit here and listen to them?
Your saviors have arrived.
I'm just trying to help you out. I like you, buddy. I like you. And I, God forbid, next, I wouldn't know what to do next Tuesday without you. I really wouldn't. I really wouldn't.
I'm waiting on steak. Why are you over here talking stuff? I know what I'm going to be doing.
I have one more question.
Okay.
One more question.
Uh-oh.
C-Rad has fed into your egos, and you guys have made all of your points, and you dominated the show. You completely took me right out of a show that I helped found, and you did what the idols do.
Good job, Brian.
You're welcome.
My question is this. Suppose Rin, Shogun, Marche, Stone, and Rose find a way to win. Then what?
We keep on doing the same shit we've been doing. What you mean, then what?
We still have every title.
What the hell? We still have the titles. It doesn't matter.
Look, yeah, what? There's no need to consider these silly hypotheticals, okay? I mean, what would I do if I woke up tomorrow and the sky was green and we were invaded by Pokemon, right? Like, right. There's no reason to ask these silly hypotheticals that can never happen, because unlike you, Steve, we live in the real world. We're practical, pragmatic, and intelligent. We make things happen here in reality. So I'm not going to even bother sinking low enough to consider your stupid little fantasy where we actually lose, because it ain't gonna happen.
What if C-Red
not great?
What if C-Red was sea turquoise? Then what? Oh! That's the type of question you ask. Then what?
He would have been solid.
What if Steve was an entertaining commentator and an intelligent human being?
Right,
no bother.
Person? He's just sea turquoise.
Yeah.
Silly.
It's a silly question.
What if you were Steve Arnott instead of Steve Aaron? Like, what do you mean?
Steve Arnott.
We can play this game all day. It's silly. Man, we can speak about hypotheticals. We can speak about what ifs.
If you fail,
there's a whole move. There's a whole saga on Disney Plus called What If. If you want to deal with hypotheticals right now, go watch it. Go stream it. If you want to deal with hypotheticals, go watch it. Don't ask us what if. Don't ask us what if, because I can ask you what if to a lot of things. What if he didn't whoop your ass and put you in the trunk? You would have still been on commentary the whole night, right?
Well, what if we would have drove a little higher and pitched him off from a little higher and he couldn't be here asking us these stupid, annoying questions? What if?
What if he was down by the river?
That's assault. That's assault.
He was down by the river.
No, it's not assault. We're talking about something that already happened. We're talking about past assault, so it's fine.
Wait. We can still get arrested for that. Chill out.
Yeah. Maybe
I got a lawyer.
Maybe in the 60s, back in the day, you couldn't do that, but I'm telling you right now.
It's still kind of fresh.
The statute of limitations or something.
It's still kind of
all right. That's fine. As much as I don't want to do this, I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to go around person by person and ask for your final thoughts, not only on what you've done, but what you're doing and where you see it going.
I have a question. Rian? Does this include me?
It does.
Damn. Okay.
Since you have become an idol, yes, I think it certainly includes you.
An involuntary honorary.
Let us make it clear.
I can start to go first for you right now, if you want me to.
No, I don't want you to go first.
Oh, okay. Oh,
I want you to continue to run down by the river. No, I'm going to give the respect where the respect is due. Joey Roth, who couldn't be here tonight for reasons undisclosed.
You don't need to know.
Said that Johnny Nye is the leader of the Joliet chapter of the Idols. So we will start with the respected leader of the Idols. Johnny Nye, the floor is yours.
Steven, my final thoughts are simple. I have been telling you for months now, each step before it happened. But the facts of the matter are, everyone in RPW, all the fans, you included, have been too ignorant to listen and heed my warnings. My final warning to you for this season is that this Saturday, in this 5-on-5 elimination match, the Idols will 100% guaranteed win and take over control of Rocket Pro Wrestling. This is not a, I'm boasting, I'm coming up with things that I don't believe are true. No, I know this. I just know it for a fact. And if you look at what I have stated in the past, which clearly, judging by your previous comments, you may not have been paying attention, but every single thing has come true. So, good luck keeping your job, sir.
Wait a minute. Hang on one second. You know, I was going to go to Gunner Brave, but I want to change things up just a little bit, if you don't mind. So let's bring a new perspective to the panel. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome former RPW champion, Shogun Chris Logan.
Oh shit, bring his bald ass in here.
Yeah, hey, hold on, Shogun. Is that a bump on your head there from me?
Wait, where is he? Where is he? Oh, beardless bastard. Looking like a shaved cat. I ain't never seen a shaved cat with a tobacco habit.
It's impressive.
You're the strongest naked people I've ever seen.
You speak.
You look like Black Caillou.
I know you ain't talking.
I can keep going, pause. Okay, swole my tail.
Listen, I know you ain't talking. Ever since you got married, you've looked a little heavier.
Chubby?
You looked a little, you know, out of shape. Looked a little sluggish.
Hey, I can lose weight. You can't grow your hair back.
And I'm okay with that. Listen.
You look like a testicle. With a gap.
That's a good one. I actually like that one. That was a good one. You've been saving that one, haven't you? That's been in the chamber for a while, hasn't it? You got anybody, my man over here dying.
I quit. You go ahead, see what you gotta say. I have to let the chamber out.
Keep going, because I need the fuel. Keep going.
No, I'm good.
And my man's got out the car.
Yeah, Rihanna, and I had to go take a walk. Shogun Chris Logan, thank you very much. Your timing is impeccable. They've run you down tonight, sir. They've run you down. They've run your chances down. They've respected you by disrespecting you in preparation for what they consider to be a sure thing that they are going to take you down because you are unable to work with the people you're tagging with. You're unable to function as a unit, and you match up very poorly against the Idols because the Idols are all better than the RPW superstars. It's fortuitous that you chose now to come because I'd like to get a counterpoint as to how maybe Team RPW is feeling just a few days before this very big match.
I just dropped in the meeting real quick. I'm a man of few words.
Indeed.
I do all my talking in the ring. See, the idols, I didn't know much about them, be honest with you, until one day I'm walking to my car, and then next thing I know, I'm getting jumped, which caught me off guard. That's my fault. I let my guard down. I'm cool with that. But not only did you jeopardize my livelihood, you jeopardized my career, you jeopardized my health, you jeopardized so many things when it comes to who I am. So these idols, these false idols, they're going around RPW causing havoc. I haven't been there for a while until I got back last month.
You're welcome.
And I'm not worried about the camaraderie with my team. I'm not even worried about that. I'm not going out there so much for the team. I'm going out there for me. I'm gonna be honest. Idols, you're laughing, you're joking, Ray. I hope you have more jokes for me by the time I get to that ring, because you know what's gonna happen.
Joe Gunn, I know exactly happen here.
I'm not even talking to you.
Oh, you're not?
The guy was making jokes.
I want it.
Thank you. You're facing
I've been waiting for that a long time. I've been waiting a long time. This is almost 10 years in waiting.
See, it's funny. It's funny.
I respect you, Shogun.
No. It's what's so funny about all this, right? Mm-hmm. You're a man on this screen. You're a man on the internet. You're a man on social media, but you're a bitch in my face.
Ooh. Oh. Ow. Whoa.
You had your chance to talk. You don't talk this shit when you walk by me at the last show. In fact, all of you idols, you stayed in one corner. In fact, we couldn't even find you guys. We couldn't find you until the end of the show. But it's funny that all of you on this screen right now is talking the most shit, but you couldn't do it until you was in that ring when everybody else was around you, when you knew that maybe somebody could save you. But it's funny. This shit is funny. That right now, all of you are talking shit. Listen, I don't even have what I do. Let's be real. In my shoot job, I don't even have motherfuckers talking to me like this. Because they know.
Right.
They talk shit at first. But then when reality kicks in, they go, oh, officer, can we talk? No. Talking is done. Right now, talking is done. See, I was coming here. I just want to say a few things, hype up the show. Let's get ready for everything. But no, I come in, I see a bunch of kids, a bunch of brats, a couple of privileged kids talking shit. Oh, y'all think y'all cool because you did affirmative action to let a black guy in, huh?
He's a founding member. That's racist.
No. All of a sudden,
wait. Let him finish. I got him when this is done.
He's a founding member. Okay.
Let him finish.
We asked Marche to join, and he turned us down.
Hey, wait, Johnny. Let him finish. He has more. Let him finish.
No, listen. I'm going to finish. I'm going to finish everything Saturday. But I'm done talking. I don't do this shit right here. When people call me to the podcast, I hype up the show, whatever. I'm not a man of many words. Y'all know me. Y'all know what I do. Mm-hmm. So you can sit up there, you can make your jokes about me, talk about my bald head. Hell, my head is huge. You can't miss it. Look at this. Yeah. It does look like a shined up testicle. I agree.
Fantastical, your mama saw him last night.
Okay.
So. So. I'm done. You say what you gotta say.
Okay, so look.
I want you to be very, very sure of your words. I want you to be careful. You can say the last word, you can say the last thing. You can say the last word right now. Doesn't matter to me. Last words don't matter to me.
Good, because I will.
Go ahead, please.
Because I will, Shogun. You know what? You said you want to be quiet. No, I'm heated for a second here. You said you wanted to be quiet and listen, and then I'll talk. Here's the thing, Shogun. You've been dismissing us as some young kids, some whatever, you know, hooligans, whatever you just said. I don't care. Because here's the thing. This weekend, I'm going to finish what I started. We're going to take Old Yeller back behind the shed. We're going to put you down. We are going to end your era of Rocket Pro Wrestling, because what you dismiss as just some young privileged kids is the next generation, is the next era. So you want me to stand and deliver? I will this weekend. We will this weekend, because all you got to say and all you got to do is just step aside and let us ascend. Let us accept our coronation, but you refuse to do so. So it's time that we take out the trash, take the Old Yeller behind the shed, and put him down. That's what it's time for.
Oh, yeah.
You're washed up. What can I say?
And see, Shogun, I'm not going to do all this hoorah shit with you. I know you. Now, see, the thing is, you come on here all high and mighty, tough chest out, with your cigar puffing and shit. But we haven't seen you since Marche whooped your ass a couple of months ago.
We haven't seen you but one time in 6 months. Who the hell are you talking?
But wait. But yet, you decided to show up, Tough Tony, shirt on. Yeah. Sounded like a special pallbearer. But yeah, you want to team up with the person that just whooped your ass a couple of months ago. Go get your title back. As a matter of fact, you know how 6ix9ine tell Dirk slide for Vaughn? You need to go slide for your belt. Don't worry about us. You got the wrong priorities right now, sir.
First of all,
at the end of the day, wait. Just like how I let you talk, let me talk.
Oh, go
this
ahead.
Is what I'm going to do right now.
You're going
to. I've known you for years.
Yes, you have.
Years and years, and I've been waiting for this moment time and time again, and I finally get to put my hands on you and show. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna give you the respect that you deserve, because you're the person that taught me what I know. You are the person that taught me what I know. I'm not gonna sit here and fake for everybody as if that isn't the truth. But see, it's time for the youngling to put you down. I'm not gonna talk about Old Yeller. I'm gonna just get in that ring and whoop your ass.
I'm not even convinced you're going to show up.
You're not convinced I'm going to show up. Look,
I'm not even convinced you're going to be in the building, Flash. You're selective with your enjoyment.
I'm not convinced you're going to show up for your next doctor's appointment, but we're not going to go here or there right now.
Wait, Flash, right? Like, you were here in the Flash, and then you haven't been in here in months, Flash, or like...
Oh, no, I was here last month, because everybody saw what I did.
You're fast in the ring, or Flash, you don't even last like 3 seconds in the bed.
It don't matter. Hey, it don't matter, because I got mine at the end of the day. No matter what you said, no matter what predicament you put me in, I got mine. If I'm in a ring 3 seconds, I got my win. If I'm in the bed 3 seconds, I got my nut. What you want to say?
I
worry about Flash. Flash worries about, I don't care about anybody else. I don't care about you. I don't care about Rihanna. I don't care about Steve.
Shouldn't you care about your wife? I mean, 3 seconds.
She married me, didn't she? She married me, didn't she?
I asked her last time, she was sure.
Hey, where's she at right now?
Where is it? What is happening?
The best part about all this is Rihanna is listening and playing Switch. This is probably one of the greatest podcasts.
This is great.
But let's get back. I'm almost done, because I want to get back to the cigars. I want to get back to my whiskey. Let's get back to
JPW,
my man
Russell Lee since now. We can keep this going.
We could.
My man earlier, he was talking about, you know, ascending, taking the old yell out in the back. I get that shit. You know, I've been telling that to my dad for years. He's being on my nerves. He's like, oh, yell it to me. I want to do the exact same thing. Okay. So I get that. Mm-hmm. But personally, I don't think you guys have the skills to ascend. Flash, the only reason I'm going to give it to you because, hell, I helped train you. So I know you have the skills. I'm not worried about you, even though you know, you're talking shit. But everybody else with the idols, right? Do you think you really have the skills to ascend? Do you think you have the fortitude to ascend? Do you think you can surpass things that I've done, things that, hell, even though I don't even like the sumbitch that Marche has done? Do you guys really believe you can do that? Don't get me wrong. You guys have been closing out the show for the past months, but it was off of cheap shit. I've been doing this for years. I never had to do cheap shit. I've ascended more and more. And to this day, hell, I'm going to tell you, I'm 39 years old. I'm still better than most of the people on the rock. So I'm going to leave with this because, like I said, I want to get back to my cigars and whiskey. Rocket Pro Wrestling this Saturday. When we get in the ring, it's no more talking. It's going to be Team RPW versus the False Idols. No more time to talk. Now it's time for action. I'm going to leave y'all with just one thing. All this shit y'all talking, as you're down on your knees, bowing to the Shogun, remember your words. I'll talk to you guys later. I love all y'all. Let me get back to the whiskey.
Shogun Chris Logan, this one's for you. Thank you.
Hold on,
there's more.
My man.
There we go.
Rion, no toast. Okay.
No, Shogun Chris Logan. I missed it. I got it.
There's the Philly card. Thank you, Shogun. Thank you for saving the day like you always do. We'll see you Saturday.
My man.
Hey, man, that was on me. I got it. We good.
Well, there you have it, folks. We heard the idols. We heard from one member of the Rocket Pro Superstars. It's on Saturday. 5-on-5 elimination. Johnny Nye, Gunner Brave, Damian Gray, Flash Harris, maybe, and Kevin Cade versus Marche Rocket, Shogun Chris Logan, Rin, Aaron Stone, and RPW champion Christian Rose. And if the Idols win, and they made some very compelling points tonight, then they take over Rocket Pro Wrestling, and I walk out the apron, I walk through the door, and I never come back. If Team RPW wins, I have a feeling the consequences for the Fabulous Idols will be delightful in September. I started this before Shogun joined us, so I'm going to go around because I'm a fair man and I want to hear your thoughts. And Johnny Nye, you just heard Shogun Chris Logan, and you did not have the benefit of seeing that before you made your final words. So I will start with the leader of the Fabulous Idols, the rock star Johnny Nye. Your final thoughts, sir.
I'll just have a couple more things. It was nice to hear from someone from Team RPW. I'm glad they have the confidence. You know, I don't know if he had a Zoom call before this with his buddies on Team RPW and came collectively to what to say. But at least one of them has a care in the world about this match. The rest of them, I haven't heard a word, not a peep. So there's one guy that seems to care about this match and about RPW, and the rest of them are just going to be quiet, and that's fine. The fact of the matter is we're a well-oiled machine. They're never going to be a collective unit. It's not good odds. I don't know if you're a gambling man, Steve, but I bet the house on the idols.
I bet the house on the superstars. Always have, and I always will. Let's move on to Damian Gray.
You know, I've pretty much for the most part said my.
You know what? I stand corrected. Let's not move on to Damian Gray.
You know what? No, Steve. We're gonna handle Damian Gray right now. You don't get to dictate. You know what? I'm gonna go. So I've pretty much for the most part said my piece. All I want to finish with is I'm sick of people ignoring the things that we've already done. They act like we're unproven. They act like we don't follow up on every single promise that we've made, but that's all we've done from the get-go. I tell you what's going to happen, and it happens. We said we were going to be champions. We became champions. We said we were going to whoop your ass, Steve, and we whooped your ass and tossed you in a river. We said we're going to get our shot at taking over this whole place. Why, go back, watch the first match of all the idols together. The first trios match we did. I said, this ain't just a match. This is a takeover. And what are we gonna do? We're gonna take over. Just like we've kept our word on every promise since. And that's all I gotta say on the matter.
Thank God. Let's move on to Outer Limits champion, Gunner Brave.
Shogun said kind of stuck with me a bit, and I'll fall under his line. I'll be a man a few words here as well. Shogun needs to realize that I have done nothing short of proving myself. I have consistently had the best match on every damn show I've been on, and I've been winning by myself, not out of disrespect or untrust to my teammates, but out of the fact that I need to prove myself to myself and to those men in the back who don't seem to believe in me, a la Shogun. So, quite simply put, we have proven ourselves. We've been proving ourselves since we came here. We will continue to prove ourselves. And once again, it's a team of losers and has-beens versus a team of champions. There's really no debate on who the better team is. I don't know why that's a question. Flash, talk your shit.
No, I'm not. Wait. I got something for you, Gunner Brave.
Oh, okay. Okay, delightful.
You that's really are a special talent.
Yes.
You really have done some incredible things.
Yes, I have.
You really have stopped the show. My best wishes to you, sir.
My worst
wishes. Let's go to Rion Skills.
What?
Your final thoughts, Rion.
Like as a whole?
Or as a whole. Final thoughts. We're running out of time. Final thoughts.
Okay. The idols.
Stop hitting people in the head. I got that part.
Like all of the idols, just do me a favor.
But you are an idol.
I'm not an idol. I'm not. I'm just, you know, a dude playing Switch. Could you possibly, if you take over, could you make longer cords so I can play Switch in the back? Like, I don't need to wrestle. I just need something to do. So if you do go over and win and be victorious, and you do decide to have me do double shifts, could you at least give me a cord so I could play like inside of the thing? I mean, if I got a sweep or something, that's fine. But I'd rather just play this and call it a day. Just help me out.
We'll take care.
We'll give you what we want to give you.
No, that's fine. That's fine. That's not a no. And I'm fine with that. At least you're thinking about it. I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
C-Red, Urban Sensation.
I did not agree
with a lot of what you had to say tonight, but you're always entertaining. Do you have final thoughts?
Entertaining? I'm right. So, Steve, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to walk in tomorrow. I'm going to see my boss, and I'm going to ask for my paycheck early. And then I'm going to bet everything I have on FanDuel on this main event match. And I'm going to go all in, per se, because I know
betting on the idols is the safest bet I could ever make. I told you. I've been telling you. I told you Flash was dominant. You didn't want to listen. I told you to stop pushing Flash's buttons. You didn't want to listen. I told you they would become tag team champions. You didn't want to listen. I told you don't put everything on Gunner or he'll break your heart. And you didn't want to listen. So again,
still have hope for him.
Yeah, after they put you in the truck and threw you in the road. Sure.
Still believe.
This Saturday in Joliet, kicks on Route 66.
Season finale.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not Paul Heyman, so this isn't a spoiler.
But you are Morris Day.
What will happen is the Fabulous Idols will reign victorious and take control of Rocket Pro Wrestling.
Eloquent as always, C-Red. Don't miss Rocket Pro Wrestling kicks on 66 this Saturday, Joliet, St. Joe's Park. It's been standing room only for months. Get your tickets because they might not be available. Get them while you can. It's going to be a show you don't want to miss. Next week on this show, we will have Mateo Valentine and Joey Mayberry as they try to air their grievances in what should be just an absolute chaotic situation. This has been... Oh, wait, did I forget something?
Oh, no.
Did I forget to give somebody some final thoughts?
I believe so.
Did I forget to hear what Flash Harris has to say as we leave this show for the evening? And before we do that, I want to thank each and every one of you. I want to thank Johnny Nye for his eloquence. I want to thank Damian Gray for his passion. I want to thank Gunner Brave for setting bars that no one will ever go above. I want to thank Rion Skills for being real. I want to thank the Urban Sensation for being the best ever. Flash Harris, I have nothing to say to you. I have nothing to say about you. The fact that I have to listen to you speak for five more minutes makes me want to fucking puke. Thoughts. Go for it, Flash. What do you got?
Grab the bucket.
The fact that you forgot about me says a lot.
Oh, I didn't.
I know that I have been the most inconsistent attendee while being the most consistent winner in Rocket Pro this year. 2022 hasn't been my year. 2021, 2022 hasn't been my year in terms of consistency and presence. I'll admit that. But in terms of my overall talent, what I bring to Rocket Pro, what I present month in, month out when I am there, cannot be argued. And that's one thing that I feel like you will always, and I mean always, have to respect. Coming down to 2022, 2023, from September to May of next year, that will be the year that Flash Harris will get your respect, get the respect of everybody in the crowd, and get the respect of everybody in that locker room. Because, see, this year has been nothing but an anomaly. Nothing but an anomaly. I haven't been able to show myself. I haven't been able to prove myself. But I've still won. And you're going to have to respect that at the end of the day. So going into this Saturday, the Idols versus Team RPW, I feel that the Idols will come out on top, roll into this offseason, and then into next season of Rocket Pro Wrestling as the owners or acting owners of Rocket Pro Wrestling do what we feel we need to do, do what we want to do, and then continue to run Rocket Pro with an iron fist. And it's one thing that you will have to respect after that, that the world's famous Fabulous Idols will be the most dominant faction to ever step foot in Rocket Pro history. I don't care if you like it, love it, hate it, or what. There will be facts proven, and it's proven right now by looking at all of the gold that's been on this Zoom call the entire time. So respect it.
You know, that's excellent. And I hope for the best in 2023. I really do. Because once upon a time, I did respect you and thought you were the very best.
It's okay. I think you think everybody's the best. That's the type of person you are. You know, I've realized you're a panderer. You pander to talent. You pander to the talent you think is the best at the moment. You know, you're flaky. You switch up. You decide when and when you win and when you want to support somebody. And that's cool. That's just who you are. And that's why I treat you the way I treat you, because you're fickle. You're not a man. You don't have nuts. You don't produce sperm. You don't reproduce. I'm not even going to disrespect you and call you out of your name, but you are not a man of fortitude at all.
Rico's anatomy lesson. Let's go.
So, let's get and
your old boy doesn't even know your name.
It's no, it's okay, because Rico, he knows Rico. He knows who Rico was. It's okay, but you don't have to know who Rico is, and that's fine. But
Flash Paisley, he's got a million names.
Thank you. That doesn't change the fact that I said what I said. At the end of the day, you are the most flip-flopping, pancaking individual I've ever seen in my life to step foot in any wrestling company. You choose who you want to support. You wait for somebody to have a wave, and then you hop on the back of that wave and expect them to take you with you. But you don't realize you're too heavy for that damn coattail. So when people like us come around, call you out, put you in your place, you hate it. That's why you hate us, because we call you out on your bullshit. And we've been calling you out on your bullshit since you stepped in Rocket Pro. So the real issue is, and the real question that you need to ask yourself from the time we leave this meeting up until Saturday, is what you're really worth, what you want, what you're looking for, and what you expect out of yourself. Don't look at it from us. You can't ride our coattails anymore. You can't ride Just Amazing's coattail. You can't ride Kane's, well, not Kane, you can't ride Gunner's coattail. You can't ride Aaron Stone's coattail. You can't ride Christian Rose's coattail. You can't ride the M80 Marche Rockets coattail anymore either. You have to be yourself. Decide to be yourself. Decide to be a man. Pick your nuts up off the fucking floor and decide to be a man for yourself for once. That's your issue. When you decide to fix that is the moment I decide to respect you. So from that point, that's why I don't like you, Steve. You don't have a backbone and you don't have nuts. You are the encompassing bitch that Shogun was talking about earlier. You thought he was talking about us, but he was really talking about you. You don't know who you are. You have no ego.
That's about enough of that bullshit.
Look at that, so scared.
On behalf of the Urban Sensation C-Red, on behalf of Rion Skills, on behalf of the Fabulous Idols, my name is Steve, and we will see you next week on the Power Hour, where our guests are Mateo Valentine and Joey Mayberry. Don't miss Rocket Pro Wrestling this Saturday night. St. Joe's Park kicks on 66, the season finale. It's going to be great. We'll see you all then. Good night, everyone.
Bye, Steve.